Hello and welcome to Design Education Talks, the collaboration between the team here of the New Art School and the Design Deducts podcast. Our guest today is Volodymyr Stasenko. Welcome, Volodymyr.
Hello, good morning, Lviv. Thank you for inviting me to talk.
Thank you for coming. Thank you so much. So tell us a bit about you and your work.
My name is Volodymyr Stasenko. I live in Lviv in the west of Ukraine. I am an artist, I am a designer, teacher. My education is quite traditional for Ukraine. I first studied in a very good professional college. The main direction of my training was decoration. According to the content of disciplines today, I will call such training proto-design. Or ever better, proto-design, protographic design. But in Soviet times, we don't use design. We don't talk so. Then I continued my studies, not on the Academy of Arts, like many of my friends, but at the Ukrainian Academy of Printing, majoring in graphic. Specialty of our training was the focus of printed products. While still a student, I began to work creatively and an artist as well as a designer at companies that began to organize after the collapse of the USSR. I must say that in the early 90s, I was one of the first designers in our region who learned to work on a personal computer. My parents work as programmers, so I was able to access computer technology as a child. I owe it to my parents to have a logical and analytic way of thinking, which is very important in the work of any designers. Because I mastered computer programs for design, after graduation, I was invited to work to the department as a trainee teacher. The position of an intern did not provide much profit, so I continued my studies, this time in the Lviv Academy of Arts. At the academy, I did my dissertation and received a doctorate in art history. My scientific work concert accident book engraving and canonical sacred images. After graduating from graduate school, I returned to teaching at the Department of Graphic and Print Design in the Ukrainian Academy of Printing. There I began to teach quite specific course related to the design of printed materials and book illustration. For 20 years of work, I had the practice of working with different courses, worked in both junior and senior courses. I taught the basic of composition, book design, developed effective visual image. For 50 years, I headed the department of the Ukrainian Academy of Printing. Initially, it was the Department of Book Graphic and Print Design, later the Department of Graphic Design and Book Art. During the work, we managed quite a lot. We managed to implement the provision of the Bologna system quite effectively in the educational process. We have successfully passed the accreditation and licensing of the direction. Working in the commission of the Ministry of Education of Ukraine became important for me. There I developed standards of education in the field of design, educational standards for baccalaureate and master developed with my participation are currently in force in Ukraine, and now we are finalizing the standards for doctors of science. I work as an expert in the Ukrainian Cultural Foundation. this is a very respectable state structure in Ukraine, and I analyze project what apply for grants.
So tell us about your practical work as a designer.
My practical work as a designer is closely related to publishing. Most of all, I work as a book designer. I also work as an advertising designer, poster developer, and company branding. In Lviv, I collaborate with several publishing houses. For example, I designed and constructed, for example, it is John Tolkien, Lord of the Rings, complex collection of Nietzsche and Friedrich Nietzsche, and another promoted philosophers. I designed textbooks and serials. I have been working at the topic of inclusion and development of materials for the blind and partially sighted for over 10 years. I came of this topic by accident because I am familiar with how to effectively convey visual information. So I model the situation and make sample with students. What is important? I design to order. When I have a rest, I do painting, graphic, and create illustration. There are my catalogs. And I am a painter and a graphic. These are my catalogs.
Nice, very nice. Very nice. So tell us about your cooperation with other education institutions.
I work very closely with the Warsaw, Kraków, and Wrocław Academy of Arts. It is not so wide from Lviv. I have many good friends there. I collaborate a little with the Baltic Academy of Arts in Riga. In 2007, I lectured at the College of Art in Ghent, it is Belgium. I had experience lecturing at the University of Nantong of China. Just before the quarantine, I returned from France, from the city of Tours, where I worked at the Academy of Arts in the graphic department. For me, in general, it is a very interesting experience to see how they teach in Europe and how in China. I also compare all this with work in Ukraine. Quarantine has drastically reduced my travels, but it is easier for an artist and a designer to survive quarantine and isolation because there it work is work in the workshop. There is still not enough time for our plans.
Absolutely, very, very good. We're always in quarantine. Absolutely. And so, tell us about design education in the Ukraine.
What can I tell you? The last few years in Ukraine have seen a boom in graphic design specialties. Many establishments have opened their designers and trained. Design departments have opened in many traditional universities, academies, and new private schools. Also, design education began to be offered at various design courses. For a long time, I was engaged in accreditation on higher education institutions in Ukraine on the field of design. Therefore, I am well acquainted with all higher education institutions in Ukraine that work in the field of art and design. In Ukraine, art and design education was best provided in the three largest centers. It is in Lviv, in Kyiv, and Kharkiv. Each city had its own specifics. For example, Kharkiv, which was a large industrial city, focused on industrial design. Graphic design was actively developed in Lviv. As Lviv was always been a powerful city where a publishing house developed. Now in Lviv, in my hometown, a lot of jobs are provided by the IT industry. So designers are oriented to this niche. Many of our graduates work in new media, animation, and computer games. If we analyze the level of training on our students, it is very high in the best academies. Graduates have world-class knowledge. Our graduates travel the world and lot get job in powerful global companies and design studios.
Oh, fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. So tell us a bit more about the education and the training that you're doing over there.
The content of modern design training is a complex and ambiguous problem. At the Academy of Printing, where I worked for over 20 years, we tried to use the most of opportunities of the Bologna educational process I told about this. This primarily concerned individual programs for students as well as their academic mobility. We had each student's own curriculum. We believed that traditional artistic practice are important for the good preparation of students. It is drawing, composition, classical graphic techniques, fonts, photos, book design. Modern media is also accessible. From the first year, we study computer graphic editors in depth. We actively worked on the development of fonts, animation, videos. In our academy, is the first year all students study the same discipline. It is in this Bologna system. In the second year of study, disciplines or free choice appear. And the last year, there are only one or two compulsory subjects left. A specific area that we once started and that has little to do with design has been the restoration of paper-based document. It is, for example, in this case, the impetus for us was this. Not design, it is not design, but the use of paper as such. And we had such a special course. We also designed packaging. We develop a lot of packaging samples. Our students take part in various international competitions. We also patent our developments in the field of ecological packaging and reuse of packaging. We patent our fonts and developments on the field of inclusive education.
Oh, that's fantastic.
I think it is a result of this Bologna system, but all our students have more possibilities to special individual study.
Absolutely, that's very essential in design education. So, what is your advice for the students and the graduates?
I think the world is very mobile now and changing rapidly. It is very difficult and impossible to clearly predict all the needs in the future, despite the fact that teachers are experienced, but the responsibility still lives with the students themselves. Teachers share their own experience, but students have to think. Self-education and initiative of students becomes very important. A lot of information can be gleaned from the web. Young people need to be careful not to waste time. And people should try not to miss your chance. In my opinion, everyone has a chance. A designer needs a very important future. We future the ability to listen to the customer. The designer must deeply understand the needs of the customer and to his job as best as possible. I think we have another problem. Often students think that they have a lot of time while studying. In fact, life in the modern world sets a high pace, and students need to be prepared for that rhythm. Think that learning is remote from life. But in the field of design, learning is very close to the relation of life. High pace, many very diverse, challenging tasks, and you need to be able to perform all tasks. Due to the great complexity of the task facing, the designer often becomes necessary to implement the project in a time. Thereof, a very good ability for a designer is the ability to work in a time. An important issue in the observance of integrity, the observance of copyright. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think copyright, it is very important problem now in our world.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. So how can we do this design education differently? What would you change, you add, replace, or remove?
I think that I don't can give students a simple recipe for learning. Why? Everyone lives a unique life and has unique opportunities. These opportunities are related to the personal preference on the young person, to the situation in society. To learn design, you need to learn to think comprehensively. We need to study the needs of customers, but we need to think deeper than the customer says. Practice in real production and firm production and firm are essential for effective training. Only during the implementation of a real project can we learn to make a real design. Absolutely. And on projects need to be coordinated with the firm which will directly implement the design. Therefore, it is important to know the technology and adherence to specification.
Absolutely. So,
yes, above replacing of removing something in the learning process. My opinion is this. When I worked as a head in the department, I managed to change everything according to my ideas. Therefore, I was satisfied with everything. And this, yes, and the students who studied with us were satisfied. Also sometimes the understanding of the structure of education to the students came over a few years of their own creative activity.
Yes, absolutely, 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 absolutely. Excellent. So, what advice would you like to leave us with?
So, General, I want to thank you for the invitation. And I will hope that my story will be useful for someone.
Thank you so much, Volodymyr. That was fantastic. That was excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for this meeting. If you want, I can speak now with you.